If I was alive at the time of Moses and I was from the Israelites, the only way to get to God by following Moses. Jesus, if I was alive at the time of Jesus, that's what we believe as the Muslims. If I was alive at the time of Jesus, for me to become a true believer of Jesus, I have to say, there's no one worthy of worship except Allah, and Jesus is the Messiah and the Messenger of Allah. And now the last prophet is Muhammad, alayhi salam. And all of them came with the same message. Worship one God, stay away from the false gods. You understand? And Allah said, Allah mentioned in Surah Zukhruf, Allah will never send a prophet and tell him to call people to worship himself. Always call people to worship one God. Jesus said, oh, hey, children of Israel, our God is one God. Clearly.
Is that true? But Jesus also said that, like, if you believe in me, you believe in my Father.
Like... Not in that. Because what Jesus came with, Allah said that, similar in the Quran, Allah said, whoever obeyed Muhammad has obeyed Allah. What does it mean?
Yeah, that means like...
Similar. Meaning, if you believe what Jesus came with, you believed what God sent him with. Now, if I say Jesus says there's one God, who I'm believing? Jesus and what God said. Because we believe every prophet's a messenger, God gave a revelation to them. You see, as Allah said, our prophet Muhammad does not speak from his own desires, he speaks from the revelation. What I say to you, Tony, we are temporary here in this life. And one day we have to live this life. And there's Christianity, and there's Judaism, and there's Islam. And each one of them claim to have the truth.
But and to be honest, every religion believes that truth.
No, they have some truth. But we believe as a Muslim, the only religion that has absolute truth is Islam. But I want you, for you to think about it. Analyze. God is not a man, but Jesus was God. But he was a man.
Yeah, because he was saying, the Trinity.
Okay, let's analyze Trinity. What I want you to do, don't be blind follower of your forefathers. God gave you intellect. Reflect upon it. Trinity, okay? Is God one or three?
It's one, but at the same time, it's, to be honest, like, I have to read the Bible. So
let's analyze. Forget, not about the Bible, Tony. It's about using intellect. You believe, I know what you believe in Trinity. You believe the Father is a fully God, correct? And the Son is fully God. How many God now?
That's two, but also the whole
I haven't come to the third one yet. No, that's... So you have two already?
Yes.
Because, for example, can we have a father as God by himself? Or is a father in need of Jesus?
They're the same, because if whatever the father is, it's the same with God, the Son.
No, what I'm asking, Tony, sorry, yeah? You know the Father?
Yes.
Is he fully God? Does he do whatever God do? Is he in need of anyone to make him God? Or is God?
God.
Independently?
Yes.
So, خلاص, we just stick with one God. Why do we need another one?
See, my Bible reflect is not really that
much. Wallahi, I have respect on you. I'm having a nice discussion with you. I forgive you if I'm rude to you.
No,
but
actually,
I'm just discussion, you know? What I would say here, God gave us intellect and natural inclination. Natural inclination meaning you don't have to go to school to learn, you should not get married to your mother. You know it within you. Like, you don't have to go to school that you should not kick a baby in the face.
Yeah, true, but the thing is this, God works in mysterious ways, like beyond how mind works.
But remember, in the Bible said God is not the author of confusion. See, and Trinity, clearly confusion. Why? Because your Father is God, He's one God. That's it, we don't need nothing. Because He does everything what God do. Then say, no. Jesus is God, but it's not two God, it's one God. No, it doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, but the thing is, it's like that. Just to show us Jesus was God, even the first miracle that he had is he had no father. He was born like just from Mary. Right?
Adam had a father.
Huh?
Adam, he had a father.
Yeah, but Adam was the first human. He was created from the ground.
No problem. What about Mary? Not Mary, sorry. Eve, who's her mother? You know what Allah said in the Quran? إِنَّ مَثَلَ عِيسَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ آدَمِ خَلَقَهُ مِنْ تُرَابٍ ثُمَّ قَالَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. Allah said to Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when the Christian Arabs came to him, he said, tell them that the similitude with Allah, of Jesus with Allah, is like Adam. Allah created him from dust and said, be. We have to understand here, the similitude here Allah is referring to, not from every angle, because Jesus was not created from dust. The similitude here was, he came to life with the word be. Adam was created from dust. but he came to life with the word be. Kun, okay? So Allah wants to show us that he's all powerful. He created Adam without a father and a mother. Because as human being, in order for me to have a child, I need a woman. Okay, woman need a man. Allah wants to show us these rules doesn't apply to him. So he created Adam without a father and a mother. Okay? And now, Eve, now for Adam to have to have a woman from him, he needs a woman. But Allah created Eve from a man, not a woman. Then Allah wants to show us that he can create a human being from a woman without a man. He created who? Jesus. You see what I'm saying? Clear. Allah wants to show us his power. However, all of them are the servant of the Creator. But however, when the Christians, when the Romans accept Christianity, they mix up the truth with the falsehood. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, one of the reasons Prophet Muhammad was sent to clarify the truth to the people of the book. Who are they? The Jewish and the Christians. Yes, Jesus was a mighty messenger. Yes, Jesus was a Messiah, the true Messiah. Yes, Moses was a true messenger. However, God gave a book to Jesus. Yes, God gave a revelation to Moses. God gave a revelation to Jesus as well. However, those revelations was mixed up. Let me make it clear to you. That's God regret. What is regretting?
Regret means you make a mistake, but God does not mistake. Make a mistake because you already know everything.
That's it. Regretting mean, imagine Tony. I said, you know, Tony, you're a good guy. I'm going to let you look after my camera here. Then I go, come back, my camera gone. So I said, I regret because I never knew. So what happened? There's deficiency in my knowledge. In the Old Testament it says, God greatly regrets for choosing Saul as a king because Saul, he turned his back on him. That's not God's nature. That's what Allah said in the Quran. When Allah decrees something, does not fear the outcome of it because Allah knows the outcome of it. I'll give you another one. Do you know why there's many languages?
Yeah, I know why there's because of the Tower of Babel and then...
So God, basically, for people to know, so God looks upon the earth and he saw people speaking one language and they start building tall buildings. And he said, nothing will stop the people now. So he came down, or the angel came down, and it caused confusion. But God doesn't care if you speak one language or you speak one tongue. God destroys everything, he's able to destroy everything. And did you know, building tall buildings, that was the belief of the Sumerians. The Sumerians used to believe, if you build tall buildings, you'll be able to reach the heaven and overthrow God.
Oh yeah, I know about that story, yeah.
See, this clear teaching is in the Bible, paganism teaching. That's why I come to Quran. Let me ask you this question, okay? Sorry, I'm speaking. Then I'll let you speak, yeah? But this question I've been asking too many people, Tony. Maybe you have the answer. I want to show you how the Quran was preserved, okay? Do you know any book, the size of the Quran, not Quran size, it has been memorized by 100 million of people who does not speak the language of the book. Do you know any book like that? You know, example is like you and all of us here, we memorize a book in Chinese, but guess what? We don't even speak Chinese. You know which book is that? Quran. You go to Africa, Asia, Europe, America, children, they don't know Arabic, but they memorize Quran, word by word, and letter by letter. Why? You know why? Allah mentioned that in the Quran 1400 years ago. Allah said, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّنَّ الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكِرِ. We made Quran easy to be memorized. And it's exactly what's happening. African children, European children, memorize the Quran word by word. This speech cannot be speech of human being. It's a speech of the creator of human beings.
That makes sense.
See, do you know who came with that? Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. When you look to the teacher Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, one God, live prophet, true prophets, Jesus, Moses, Abraham.
One thing I don't get is, if that's the case,
ask any question.
Why didn't like God bring the whole revolution in one thing and give it to maybe Abraham? Because before, obviously, like Jesus, Abraham was the big, the greatest prophet before Jesus.
Sorry, I didn't say the question. Say it again.
Before, like, instead of giving it to Muhammad, why don't God give the whole revolution to Abraham?
Yeah.
Because, like, Abraham was the start of Abraham's religion, so obviously, Judaism, Islam.
Okay. First of all, what we say, all of us here as a Christian and Muslims, we have to agree, we don't question God. Okay? You see? God question us. However, God, based upon his wisdom, there were prophets and there were nations. Some teaching that gave to some prophets, it was specific for that nation. You see, that's why we say the reason God sent another prophet, that's the reason. Like, to make clear, why we believe Prophet Muhammad to be the last prophet? Why? Because the reason for God to send another prophet, because the first prophet, his teaching was specific for his time. So people changed, developed, evolved, not evolved like for monkeys, no, even mean in their life. Yeah. So in their lifestyle. So God sent another prophet. The other reason, the first prophet's teachings be corrupted. So God will send another prophet to correct that teaching. The last reason, God will send the prophets to aid prophet that was sent, like John and Jesus. Or, likewise, the last reason, prophets will send for specific time and specific nation. After Prophet Muhammad was sent, all these reasons been removed. After Prophet Muhammad was sent, he was sent to everyone. Okay? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his teaching was preserved. Okay? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if Allah would send another prophet, he would send it in his time. So likewise, after Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam died, Islam spread far east, far west. So God does things based upon his wisdom and his mercy and justice. But what I want you to understand, as a Muslim, I believe the Jews that rejected Jesus, they will go to the hellfire. But likewise, I believe the Christian that reject Prophet Muhammad, they will go to the hellfire if the truth was clarified to them. Because what you have to understand, Tony, Jesus never claimed to be Christian. What was his belief?
Obviously, to start with, he was Jewish.
Obviously, there was no Jewish anyway, by the way. There's no Jewish term in the Bible. He was Israelite to me.
Yeah,
that's his ethnic. That's his background. What was his belief?
Normally, from what I know or what I believe, he believed that he came for a sin of mankind.
Did he believe in one God?
He believed he is God.
No, he never believed he's God. No,
that's
never.
The whole reason, like, they killed him.
No. He never believes he's God. He never. You know why? Because if you believe... Make clear. That's God has a God. Jesus said, I'm going to my God and your God. Can anyone guess, please? When Jesus said, I'm going to my God and your God. It's so clear. Wallahi, do you believe the Bible has been changed?
To be honest, like, I believe most things have been changed because, like, you can tell with some messed up, even if you read the Bible, some of the things, they've been corrupted because in some Bibles, if you look at it, it says if you're not supposed to fast, they'll cut it out.
Yeah.
That's just simple thing. In Orthodox Bible, we say you need to fast and pray.
Okay.
In Jehovah's Witness, they cut
so
it.
You accept the Bible's been changed?
Yes, I do.
Okay, Tony, look at this. Would the most merciful God, the most just God, the most wise God, would he leave us with a corrupted book, or would he clarify the truth to us?
He would clarify it to us, but the thing is, at the same time, in the Bible, I'm not really sure what page it is, but whoever corrupted the word.
It's true. And they still corrupted it. They don't care. So he will clarify the truth to us. Do you know what is that truth? In the Prophet Muhammad teaching.
But another thing I wanted to ask you as well.
Go on.
You know, most of the prophets, they're Jewish or Israelites. If you look at that, even from Abraham all the way to Jesus. But Muhammad is the only prophet that has come out. And he's not an Israelite.
Who's Abraham Israelite?
Abraham, to be honest, he's a Sumerian or Babylonian.
So he's not Israelite? Was he a prophet of God? He was a prophet of God. Was Noah Israelite?
Noah has God.
Yeah, back then
he was not Israelite, no. However, yes, there were prophets among the Israelites, a lot of them. However, God wants to test the Israelites. Are they following the prophets of God because they are prophets of God or because they are from their nation? So God sent a prophet from there, the Arabs. Not the Arabs. Muslims mean, we believe Jesus was a Muslim. That's what I was asking you. Muslim doesn't mean you're Arab or Pakistani or Jamaican. Muslim means someone who submits to God's will, surrendered to his oneness, to his obedience, and free himself from the shirk, from polytheism. That's what it means. Doesn't mean you're a Pakistani yourself, yeah. What country are you from?
Ethiopia.
Ethiopia. So what I would say to you, Tony, yeah? So, what do you call it? I was going to mention one point. No. What was the point again? I forgot. What was it again? Prophet. Yeah. Allah tested them. So So Allah sent prophets from the Arabs. But you know what? Can anyone go to Isaiah 42? I want to show you something. I want to show you that Quran and what Prophet Muhammad came with cannot be from human being. It has to be from God. And if this is the case, you have to accept the truth. Do you know why? Because you and I, we know God the most wise, will not choose a liar to convey his message. Correct? Without any doubt. So if we establish Prophet Muhammad to be true prophet, logic dictates you should believe what he came with. Otherwise, you'll be contradicting yourself.
You are right. But one thing as well, like, you know, from the Bible, now I don't know if it's been cutted out or something, but like, when Jesus was, before the coming of Jesus, other prophets were talking about him.
I believe
and
that,
like, even with other prophets before they came, there was like, they've been talking about them, but I'm not sure if there's like that in the Bible.
That's what I was going to come for. Isaiah 42. Alhamdulillah, Allah made you speak before. I'll show it to you. I'm going to show it to you. Isaiah 42. Here is my servant, whom I upload. I uphold, sorry. My chosen one, in whom I delight. I will put my spirit on him. He will bring justice to the nations. You just mentioned something. If you go to King James translation, he says he will bring justice to the Gentiles. And the Gentiles are the non-Jews. Yes. But this just changed to nations, okay? I will put spirit upon him. Allah said, رَفِيعُ الدَّرَجَاتِ دُلْرُوحِ رَفِيعُ الدَّرَجَاتِ دُلْعَرْشِ يُلْقِي الرُّوحَ عَلَى أَمْرِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ يُلْقِي الرُّوحَ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ عَلَى مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah mentioned about him. He's Allah is the owner of the great throne. And he will put spirit upon to whom he chooses. The spirit here, do you know what it means? Revelation. So when he said he will put a spirit upon him, means revelation will reveal to him. That's exactly what Allah said in the Quran. He will not shout or cry out or raise his voice in the streets. Bruise reed, he will not break. As small, there's many things here. But the main point here, watch this. To open the eyes of the blind. I am the Lord, that is my name. I will not yield my glory to another or my praise to idols. See, former things have taken place and the new things I declare. If you go to Hebrew, here means new law. And we know Jesus, any prophet come after Moses, came with the Mosaic law. Okay, watch this. Let the witness or sing to the Lord new song. Mean new law, yeah? Let the witness and his towns raise their voice. Let the settlement where Kedah live rejoice. Who's Kedah?
Kedah.
Okay.
I don't know that.
I'll come tell you. Let the people of Selah sing.
Selah.
So there's Kedah. There's Kedah and there's Selah. Go to what's this? Yeah. Yeah, go to Genesis 25:13. Genesis 25:13, he says, these are the names of the sons of Ishmael. Sons of who? Ishmael.
Ishmael, that's Abraham's son.
Yeah, the Ishmaelites, yeah. First, Nabiyot, 25:13, watch this. No, 25:13, I think.
Oh, 25.
Yeah, so he says, these are the names of the sons of Ishmael. The first born is Nabiyot. You know the second one? Kedah. So these servants of God here, for you to read. No.
My brother, these you say you're descendant from Ishmael.
Yeah.
Okay.
These are the names of sons.
But there's no kings in Ishmael.
Sorry, you can read. There's princes, 12.
12.
Yeah.
No,
there
are the name of the sons of Ishmael.
Only from Israel.
First born of Ishmael.
Yeah.
First born of Ishmael. Okay.
That's beautiful. That you know
that's it. Abdul Misam.
Okay. First of all, these are the names of the sons of Ishmael. So the first. Remember Isaiah speaking about Kedah. Why God is specifying let the people of Kedah rejoice?
Yes.
Do you know why?
Why?
Historically speaking, from the Muslims and the non-Muslims, that when you go, no one came and made the people of Kedah rejoice except Prophet Muhammad. And the mountain of Selah is in Medina. Selah. Mountain of Selah. Do you remember? Let the people of Selah sing. Mountain of Selah, and it's exactly what happened. When Prophet Muhammad migrated from Mecca to Al-Madinah, the people of Medina rejoiced. and they became very happy. And this prophecy, Tony, was used, do you know by who? By rabbis at the time, Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. They used it to prove their people, Prophet Muhammad was prophesied in our books.
I need to actually learn a lot.
Check it. You know, it's funny. When I had Jehovah's Witnesses, they came to the houses.
Yeah, they came.
I said to, do you know about Isaiah 42? Said to, you know what? I don't know it. I'm going to call my scholar to come visit you. What day you'll be home? I said, Friday morning, I'll be here. So they come Friday. The scholar is coming back, remember? And so we're speaking about it, clarifying it. You know, we need to bring another scholar.
I love the fact that you use the Bible as a reference to clarify what you want to say.
Yeah, because
I'm happy that you do that.
Yeah, alhamdulillah.
That means we can glory in the Bible.
No, it means there's some truth in it. There is some truth in it.
Yeah, to be honest, it's not.
I believe some truth in it.
But the Almighty says that no king shall come from Ishmael.
But there was prophet from Ishmael.
Yeah, there was prophet, but no king.
So do you accept this prophet Muhammad?
Yeah. No.
So which prophet came from Ishmael?
Then you'd have to have a different conversation.
So this Isaiah 42 is so clear. Even there's another prophecy in the Bible says, a book will be given to someone. He said, read. He said, I'm not learned. Hold a minute. This never happened in history. I can't remember which passages in Isaiah. A book will be given to someone. He said, read. He said, I'm not learned. In history, it never happened except with one prophet. When the angel Gabriel came to Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, read. He said, I cannot read. I'm not learned. I cannot read.
Isaiah 29.
Isaiah 29, 12. You are study, learn. Where are you from, Tony?
Ethiopia, I told you.
No, area.
Area, I'm from Southampton.
Southampton. Where is Southampton again? East London.
No, Southampton. North Korea.
Oh! Where is this? East Southampton. There's Southampton as well. But there's one in next to Birmingham.
Wolverhampton.
What about the one after Hammersmith?
Wolverhampton.
Okay, forget it anyway. English names, New York, York City. Anyway, you can take my number if you want. You can ask questions and we have discussion. Because why, as I've told you, God gave you him as a human being. You have your own brain. And I believe without any doubt, there is no salvation except by following Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And I believe at the time of Jesus, there was no salvation except by following Jesus amongst the Israelites. So if you want to take my number, exchange number, WhatsApp me. A friend of mine, Ethiopian, he became a revert as well, become Muslim. Alright, do you want to exchange numbers?
But first, Jesus.
It's up to you, no problem. But do research before it's too late. Don't lie, because it was clear to you, study before it's too late. Alright, Tony, thank you very much. Take care, man.
Just like all you can guide him.
And may Allah guide us and guide him to the truth, man.